Hey everyone, welcome to another exciting episode of Let's Bully the Kid Who Just Sits Around and Watches Movies because he clearly has no life, this time in October. But joke's on you bitches, it was actually a pretty slow month because I actually have a life. I started off the month watching the South Park pandemic special and it was... meh. I normally love South Park and everything that they do, but lately they've been kind of overstaying their welcome. And when I heard that they were doing an hour-long episode about the pandemic, I just said to myself, of course they are. And then I watched it, and everything I predicted to happen, happened. Of course someone from South Park was going to be responsible for starting the pandemic. Of course one of them was going to lose their minds. And of course they were going to put in a police brutality thing. It just felt so on the nose to me, and I was surprised at how much I didn't laugh. Don't get me wrong, I laughed at a few things like how far they took Randy's subplot, and the message at the end is pretty bittersweet, but I just felt like they made it just because they felt like they needed to. South Park just isn't really all that surprising anymore. Then I went to the drive-in with a couple friends and the first movie they played was Hocus Pocus. It was fun, it was nostalgic. I had this movie on all the time as a kid because my sister really loves it. I feel weird reviewing this because it's so obvious that all it's trying to do is just give the audience a goofy fun time, and it succeeds at that. Everyone in the cast looks like they're having so much fun. Does it get a bit too goofy at times? Well, considering the fact that it opens with a guy who's supposed to be in the 1600s and he still has his surfer dude accent, and the fact that the high school bullies look like they're in their 30s, yes, absolutely. But it was a blast to the past, and I enjoyed my time. The second movie they played was Beetlejuice, which was my first time watching it, and that was fun too. I definitely enjoyed the aspect with Alec Baldwin, Gina Davis, Winona Ryder, and Michael Keaton, where it showed Tim Burton's true creative visual style. But the aspect with Winona Ryder's family trying to buy the house was so boring to me. Minus the banana boat scene, which was so beautifully bizarre, every time they cut back to that family and the real estate agent, it grinded the movie to a complete halt and it made me like the movie less, and they do it a lot. But aside from that, there were some truly great elements. The afterlife world reminded me of Dr. Caligari. Michael Keaton is beautifully energetic and steals the whole movie. Winona Ryder is truly great, and the ending is great. But damn, when it's boring, it's boring. And then I watched Save Yourselves, and I kinda loved it. This thing is a total blast, and it's a very clever take on the alien invasion story, but less focused on the horror aspect of it, and more focused on the comedic aspect of it. It's a commentary on how people are glued to technology, and of course we've seen commentaries on that before time and time again, but the way this movie handled it was very funny and clever. And it has a very underrated soundtrack. Sunita Mani, I hope I said that right, and John Reynolds are both really charming leads, and this is written wonderfully. It's one of the best scripts I've heard all year, and this is one of the funniest movies I've seen all year. Catch me watching this 1,000 times. Then I watched Corpse Bride, because after watching Beetlejuice, I felt the need to catch up on some Tim Burton. It was alright, but not really my thing. The songs are okay and the animation is gorgeous, but I didn't really connect with any of the characters. It all felt kind of bland to me, and that's sadly the case for most of Tim Burton's movies now. You can have gorgeous animation, decent voice acting, and decent music, but the movie lacks charm, therefore I can't really get connected to the artistic style going on. And for that, there's really no reason for me to care. I honestly forgot that I watched this, and honestly, I can't remember too much about it. Then I watched The Lost Boys, and... blah. I'm sorry guys, I know this is a cult favorite, and I wanted to flat out love this too, but I walked out thinking it was just okay, I guess. Is this entertaining? Sure, but that doesn't change the fact that I didn't give a shit about anything that was going on at all. It all just felt a bit too cheesy, and I get that's the point, but the movie felt like it was trying to be so many things at once. There are times where it feels like it's taking itself way too seriously, and then there are times where it's clearly not taking itself seriously at all, and it really started to annoy me, and when I wasn't annoyed, I was bored. These characters, in my opinion, were so forgettable and bland, and their acting wasn't good for the most part. Yes, the movie is undeniably entertaining at times, and the ending is cool, but that doesn't change the fact that I was annoyed. And if you like it, that's awesome. Please, like it. Maybe it's just me and I'm missing something, but I honestly don't really want to watch this ever again. Then I attended the Hamptons Film Festival and watched The Sound of Metal, Nomadland, I Carry You With Me, Minari, 9 Days, and The Climb. All which I did videos on, so check out those reviews, and also I rated them on those reviews. Then I watched On the Rocks, and I'm pretty disappointed. Sofia Coppola is undoubtedly one of my favorite directors. 3 of her movies are some of my favorite movies of all time. And I know not all of her movies are great, and this isn't even her worst film. I don't even think it's really all that bad, but she can do way better. First off, this is one of the ugliest movies I've seen all year. It has a dark blue color palette that makes everything so weirdly dark and dull, and maybe that's just some artistic choice Coppola made, but all it did was it made me not want to look at the movie. And I could forgive all of that if the editing wasn't also so bland. Combine both ugly cinematography with bland editing and you get a pretty boring movie across the board. The performances are fine, Bill Murray is honestly the standout, his character was the most charming and interesting, but literally anyone could have played Rashida Jones's character. I don't remember a single thing about her character or her performance, and Jones didn't really bring all that much to her performance. She's just bland, and I know I keep saying that about this movie, but that's the best way it can be described. It's bland. It has some cool shots, and aside from Bill Murray, I did enjoy Marlon Wayans' performance, but I'm just gonna forget about this. Then I watched the Rocky Horror Picture Show, and I wasn't prepared. This thing pretty much kicks ass, but on the other hand, what the fuck? If I'm being honest, this is one of the most stylistically pleasing movies I've ever seen. The production design is some of the best I've ever seen. The attention to detail in this thing kind of floors me, and it kept me hooked with every scene. It knows exactly what it is and what it wants to be, and it isn't afraid to go fully weird, which I loved. It kept me wondering what was gonna happen next, and it made me love every character more despite how odd they are. Not every song worked for me, and honestly some of them go on for a bit too long, but that doesn't change the fact that this is one of the most entertaining movies I've ever seen. It's iconic. Then I watched Hubie Halloween for some reason. I went in expecting an Adam Sandler movie, and that's what I got, but like, I can't be the only person who thought this was boring as shit. And then I watched Shiva Baby, and yes, yes, yes! This is one of the most anxiety-inducing movies I've seen in a while. I won't spoil what or how much exactly happens that makes it anxiety-inducing, because honestly, I didn't know where this was gonna go, but every minute, the main character is constantly put on edge, and the pressure just keeps building and building and never stops, and the haunting musical score plays along with the intensity. It's absolutely chaotic, and it's all done so well. The comedy here also works so well. Holy shit, this movie is so funny. The comedy is played in such a subtle way. With a film like this that's trying to raise some anxiety, the comedy wouldn't really work, but in this movie, every joke felt so in place and in character. Emma Sligman is a director and writer to look out for. This is one hell of a directorial debut. She balances the comedy, anxiety, and sensitivity of the subject matter perfectly. She builds tension in a way that's so unique, it kept my attention every single time. And if you're not paying attention, you may miss something. And I can't wait to see her career skyrocket after this. And I'll gladly support everything that she does. And I'll gladly support Rachel Sonnet, I hope I said that right, in everything. This movie is only doing film festival runs right now. It doesn't even have a trailer or release date. What I'm showing you right now is clips from the short film that this is based on. But please see this when you can. It's one of the best of the year. Then I watched Borat, subsequent movie film. The first Borat I think is great, and I would consider it one of my favorite comedies, and this sequel I feel did what it needed to do. Having Sacha Baron Cohen and Maria Bakalova flat out troll these kind of people who deserve it felt so incredibly satisfying, and a great amount of the jokes worked. Sacha Baron Cohen may be one of the best actors ever, but can we please talk about Maria Bakalova for stealing the entire movie? What she does in this movie and her ability to not break character absolutely blew my mind. Yeah, this movie's pretty great. It's not as funny as I wanted it to be, some gags go on for longer than they should, but when the humor works, it's absolutely outrageous. This is the movie we all need right now. Then I watched Possessor, and it was really cool, but I definitely need to watch it again because I honestly just didn't get it. And then I watched Jennifer's Body. This thing surprised the hell out of me. I expected this to be some generic teen horror movie, but what I got was kind of that, but it's also a really great character study on both Jennifer and Needy. They managed to explore each other's friendship so well, and within the first 10 minutes of the film, you feel like you already know everything you need to know about them, and I can say that there are things from both characters that I can relate to. And aside from that, the horror elements range from working really well to not really working much at all. There are points where they drag these scenes out, and it's pretty much pointless to do that because you know what's gonna happen. Not only that, but the dialogue also definitely feels very dated. Other than that, Jennifer's Body knows exactly what it is. At its heart, it's a goofy movie that's not asking you to take it so seriously and to just have fun. And I love that about this film. This will probably be a Halloween tradition from now on. Also, this movie invented feminism. And then I watched Edward Scissorhands and it was beautiful. This right here, this is Tim Burton's best film, hands down. Not only is it the most artistically pleasing out of all his movies in my opinion, but every character is written to near perfection. Aside from the antagonist, I found myself loving every single person in this. From the very beginning, the film shows its true heart and acceptance for everything around it because, just like us, every character except for the antagonist understands that they'll never understand what Edward has to deal with. It's executed beautifully, and this might be my favorite Johnny Depp performance. The ending is also the most bittersweet thing ever, and Danny Elfman's score is a top 5 of all time for me. Also, thanks to this movie, it confirmed that Winona Ryder is officially my celebrity crush in terms of the film industry, but like, you couldn't get an actual old woman to play the older version of Kim. 20-year-old Winona Ryder looks so weird in old age makeup, look at that! And finally, I watched Black Bear. I really liked it, but I don't really want to say much about it because I genuinely did not know where it was going to go. You just had to see it for yourself. All I'll say though is Aubrey Plaza for President 2020. And there you have it. Sorry it's a bit late, I've been very exhausted lately because I just started a new job, and that job requires me to be up early most days, so I'm pretty much passing out once the day is over. But yeah, the new job is pretty cool so far, just don't be surprised if I get too tired to make a video. But what I have planned next is a video essay for Luca Guadagnino's We Are Who We Are, which I also watched this month and loved. I'll probably have it up at some point. My goal is by the end of the month. If that's not the next video, then something else will. But yeah, look forward to whatever I do next. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.